Dr. Kesselman from Cornell Elementary Radiology. Here today we're using the Mentice unit to demonstrate pelvic embolization for trauma. This is our fellow here, Dr. Smith. So for trauma, there's a couple considerations in terms of embolic agents that you can use. For the most part, we're using either gel foam, which is a temporary embolic, or coils, which is a permanent embolic. For gel foam, there's a couple different preparations. Here we most often use a gel foam slurry. So that's where you cut up the gel foam, you swish it through a three-way stopcock with a combination of saline and contrast, and that gives you a solution that will be embolic for these kind of procedures. That's good to consider when you have kind of diffuse injury or you're unable to get there with a microcatheter in order to deliver a coil more selectively. Now for focal injury or somewhere where you can deliver a coil more selectively, what you're going to want to do is use one of two types of coils, either detachable or pushables. Here on the Mentice, we're going to demonstrate detachable coils, which are a little bit more precise. Dr. Smith here has already demonstrated the active area of extravasation. I'm going to do an injection. And you can see that that's the vessel that he's looking to coil across the area of extravasation. Just tell them what you're doing.
Yeah, so I'm going to get the wire and the catheter past the area of extravasation to start my coiling.
Perfect. So for this part, he's going to pull the wire back. Our wire is actually going to become our pusher for our coil. So once that's deactivated, I'll help him out here and select the coil. Okay. So you want to discuss a little bit what's going on?
Yeah, so now that we see the wire or the coil coming through and it's getting out of the catheter, we're gonna
pull back a little bit.
Coil.
Yep. So you can see there he delivered one of them. Alright, then pull back the wire and then we'll deliver a couple more. I'm gonna pull back the micro a little bit and we'll deliver a little bit more proximal. Let me give you another coil. There we go.
Pull back the catheter slightly until the coil registers. I'm placing it out here.
So you can see him placing the coil right there. It's bunching up in the vessel, and that kind of causes the mechanical obstruction. And now he's going to place one more just proximal to that area of injury.
Again, there's the coil coming around, and then you see it coming out of the microcatheter.
Good. Maybe one more. We'll do one more coil, and then we'll do a final run. And coiling across the area of injury, the extrav or pseudoanastom, allows you to prevent back filling through a collateral vessel or anything like that. Okay, so he'll do a little puff now and we'll just see what it looks like. If we still need to put a couple more coils, we can. But hopefully this takes care of the injury. You want to do DSI?
Yeah.
There we go. And we see that vessel's been occluded and that should take care of the bleeding. And normally, in a normal situation, the patient's vitals will start to improve. All right, well, thank you, and everybody stay safe.